selling city-owned property better than what we've experienced. We failed miserably, not his fault, as a city, we failed miserably on FIA, right? We sold it, we got sold a bill of goods on a $15 million bank facility, it sat vacant, it's dilapidated, they didn't pay taxes, it looks like garbage, we're finally gonna go somewhere with it. We failed miserably next to the post office, right? Happened to be the same guy, not sure how that happened, but we were gonna have this nice big development, and it was garbage, and we're finally getting somewhere. We have proven beyond a reasonable doubt that we're incapable of selling our own property and turn it into something that we believe it can be turned into. We had Tom Long here earlier. We have Tech Real Estate. We have all kind of professionals in the city that we could partner with and say, hey, we have this parcel. Maybe the guys next door want it. Maybe somebody in New York wants it. Let's market it. Let's do this the correct way. And let's see what we can get so we get the best bang for taxpayers. That would be my recommendation.
I agree with that, but I also would like to see good business policies too with partners already in the community.
Oh, absolutely.
Attorneys, but I think we might walk a very thin line here.
To the chair,
whatever. I know four of them were, you know, for marijuana. The top one, to me, I thought that was a, I tried to research them, it's a reality.
Yeah, Brian is here from that company.
So it's an investment, property investment. So it's, and so I'm a little confused on that, that they would buy it and they would sell it to somebody else?
No.
Rent it out to somebody else?
Oh, I understand.
That's where I'm confused on that.
What do people buy it by?
He looks familiar.
David, I've heard from you, London Road Cross and Jet, office 4 or 5,000 River Ridge Drive, Tim Thompson, Michigan. Don't kill a messenger, but. Yeah, we represent an investment company, influx of how we sell goods and distribute goods, and that really has changed drastically. You probably saw Harper Woods, Eastland Mall has now become a distribution center, Shelby Township, Romulus. So we have logistic companies regionally that are very interested in this location with a spec building of 6,000, 8,000 square feet that could service the new way to do business in selling retail goods. So essentially, we thought that was, we were made aware of this became available to us, and so we submitted a letter of intent, a couple rounds of that. We ended up being the highest bidder, and that's why I'm here today. But other than that,
So I'm gonna finish off with this, is just to let the residents know, because a lot of this is really confusing to a lot of our residents in the U. So you are a company that put a bid on this, and you put, and so I'm really kind of confused. So say for example, Mr. Bezerra has, or Mr. Bezerra has a company out there, and he wants to open up a, you know, a dispensary or something like that. He would come to you and buy the property from you.
We are a development company, a real estate investment company. So we go ahead and build a building, and then a spec building. Say, instance, Chewy.com wants to have a distribution center or a logistics center that's close to where their regional warehousing locations are. So then we would build that out to their specs, we would lease that.
So you would lease it. That was my question. You're not selling it to somebody else. You would be. Now, the other companies here are those who want to buy the building or buy the property to build their own facility, correct? Out of the other four that were in here.
How did you hear about the availability of this property?
Our client, I don't know how they came about. I'm just a real estate attorney and asked the draft.
We didn't put a sign up, we didn't really market it.
No, I didn't.
Is it spelling?
Yeah, it's a little wordy, which put it in here.
But I may be wrong, but it's on CoStar. It's on our website, all our city owned property. It's on CoStar.
So why would they advertise it?
Typically is. They typically look at and say, do our CoStar, which is kind of like your realty.com.
So it was up for how long? And we got, it sounds like we got 5 minutes.
Chair, more of the property has been listed on our GIS, as long as we have our GIS up in public. So anybody who is interested in looking at our city properties that are for sale are on our website, on our economic development page. So it's been there longer than probably been before my tenure.
So we've had it up for years and years and years. Nobody's inquired on it, or I'm asking. Doesn't sound like anybody's inquired on it. You gentlemen by next door, they include next door, they say, hey, let's see if we can get it. And then in conjunction with that, a bunch of other people happen to find it on CoStar and they made this too, is that correct? Or did you reach out to parties and say, are you guys interested?
Well, I don't know how they came through. Tia might know if she's using it to call, but I would ask you, gentlemen, how did you come across that? Did you call Tia?
We work right next door.
Oh, it's attached
to our property. So you just kind of call the city and say,
when the water's flowing from there onto our property, we're noticing it, pretty much.
Many times of what happens that you will have somebody who is a broker, and that broker will call the city and say, hey, we saw this property on your website.
Walk through the process of accepting the bids. It sounds like you're the one that's kind of managed this. Can you, we've got a document that's showed bids between $200 and $245. Was it a sealed bid process? Were these all